Welcome. It's a great day to be a miner. Today we have once again affiliated with our friends over at Parallel Miner to bring you an exciting upgrade to a very innovative piece of hardware. It really is a game changer, but with a little twist. We're going to dive into it, but first, let's spin that intro. Pew! Welcome, this is the ZSX Game Changer, and this is the ZSX Amp. If this thing changed the game, then this thing just leveled it up. Let's discuss the improvements and the changes on the Rev2 version of the ZSX, some of its specs, some of its features, as well as a quick setup guide. This is the predecessor to the Game Changer. To recap why the ZSX is known as the Game Changer, this beautiful little product has allowed us to essentially replace the ATX power supply altogether without the need of additional adapters such as a Pico adapter. To see my full review on the ZSX Game Changer, go ahead and click up in the description and check out that video and leave me some feedback on it. Just like its predecessor, the ZSX Amp combines three amazing products into one board. Obviously, it's a server power supply breakout board with 16 of the 6-pin PCIe power slots, but this board also integrates the 24-pin plus the 4+4-pin CPU power needed to power the motherboard. It also adds a full fan hub and has a SATA and Molex plug for SSD, HDD, and accessory support. So let's talk about what sets this thing apart from the original ZSX Game Changer. Then we're gonna go through some of its specs and some of its features. So let's start with first, the biggest and most important change, the additional current display. This beautiful little display shows us the live amp reading so that you can see the full power draw that's flowing through the board and powering your rig. Next involves some quality of life and layout changes. For one, the fan hub has been slightly redesigned. They have eliminated the red slots that were on the previous version on the ZSX Game Changer, and now they are all black. This will help alleviate some of the confusion. These are normal fan slots and could be used as so. Additionally, they have reduced it to 1 PWM. That way you can control all 10 fans with a single cable running over to your motherboard. Again, this is optional. If you do not use the PWM cable, you will get 100% fan speed from the connectors. Real quickly, I wanted to mention that Parallel Miner does offer a 10x4-pin extension chassis fan kit on their site for only around $14, and I highly recommend picking one of these up. This will give you greater reach for your fans to plug in, as well as give you a much cleaner setup and not have the spaghetti effect with your wiring. Next, they have moved the remote section on the breakout board. They have moved it away from the 24-pin and away from the main socketed section so that it signifies that this should not be plugged in unless you are using the remote functionality. There had been a number of other users that have improperly plugged in this socket and caused damage to the breakout board. Make sure you are using this only for remote capabilities and not to power Molex or SATA adapters. Additionally, they have moved and made the LED display quite a bit easier to view. It has moved down here in the corner, but it has spaced the LEDs slightly farther apart, and this makes it easier to view and to know which LED is actually illuminated when they are on. It is a very nice little touch that they have added on this. And finally, the PCIe plugs have moved slightly, but that is to accommodate the additional size on this breakout board. As you can see, the original Game Changer is just a little over a half inch shorter than the new ZSX Amp Edition, where they have accommodated the additional power meter on here. So let's hop over and discuss some of the quick features, and then we'll go into our setup. ZSX Amp breakout board features. It features 16 PCIe 6-pin connectors on your board. It also has the integrated 24-pin to 24-pin and 4x4 CPU pin Pico adapter on the board right here. And then it also has the integrated DC amp power display up here and the integrated voltage display right here. And it also features the integrated fan hub down here at the bottom. It also highlights the onboard LED power in, power out, and motherboard power display indicators right here. This board also highlights the remote section over here where you can plug into a remote adapter. And the board also highlights dual mini 4-pin daisy chain connector plugs that will allow you to hook multiple server power supplies up to this one breakout board, allowing you to power on all of the subsequent power supplies with just the power from this board. This board has a built-in power button right here. This board also supports up to 2400 watts, which just happens to be the same amount of power supplied from the Delta 2400 watt beast that Parallel Miner supplies. Make sure to check out my video in the description above for that beast of a power supply as well. The final feature on this and the ZSX Game Changer are, of course, the beautiful insulated plexiglass backplating that they both offer. I'll go ahead and peel back the one on the original Game Changer and show you. It is a thick plexiglass, black plexiglass. It looks quite sleek, and what this does is it protects the solder joints and it keeps any shorting out from occurring. So you're probably asking yourself, what exactly comes with the ZSX Amp breakout board? Well, for one, you get the ZSX breakout board. For two, you get the heavy duty 24-pin to 24-pin and 4x4 CPU cable. And then also you get the Molex to Molex and SATA adapter. It comes already slotted into the breakout board. And this is simply for the purpose so that you do not get confused and accidentally plug this plug into the remote section on this board, which could cause damage. So let's quickly do a setup and show you how this all should be connected. So first off, we have our breakout board, and we have, this is a HP 1200 watt server power supply that we're going to use for demonstration. Let's go ahead and slot that in. You want to get a nice even pressure across the slot and push it in. That way you do not flex it and cause any kind of damage to either the breakout board or the server power supply. Now we have that slotted in. It made a nice firm click and it is firmly on there and connected. Next, we need to go ahead and hook our 24-pin into our 24-pin in the breakout board, and then it will run to our 24-pin and our 4x4 CPU pin on our motherboard. 24-pin and click. Nice even pressure. And here is the 24-pin that will run to your motherboard to supply power. And here is your 4x4 CPU power that will plug into the motherboard to supply power to your processor. The next thing you need to hook up will be your Molex to Molex and SATA adapter, and that will be used to power your hard drive or your solid state drive if you are using one. Make sure to slot it into the slot that clearly labels SATA and not to the slot that is labeled remote. If you plug in your Molex into your remote and then you run it to some of your other components, it can backfeed and cause irreversible damage to the breakout board, server power supply, or other components. Please do not do this. Here is our Molex to Molex and SATA firmly pushed in. Run this over into our solid state drive. And then the next thing we need to do is hook up our fans to our integrated fan hub right here. We would run these out to each additional fan in our rig. Then if you want to use the PWM control, you would run this plug over to your motherboard, fan chassis one, and then you could control all of your fans with your motherboard support. or you can just plug in your fans with no PWM and you have 100% fan speed, fan power running through each of these connectors. And as a miner, I would think that's probably the way to go. And that's what personally I do with all my rigs, because I'm not sure why you would ever want your rig fans to run at less than 100% power. So now we have everything hooked up except for our PCIe cables to our GPUs and to our risers, of course. So then we need to get our 6-pin power adapters. We're going to firmly slot this into one of the 6 pins on the breakout board, like so. Then we're gonna run this to either our GPU or our riser, or we're going to split this power using a splitter that we can split 6-pin into dual 8-pin. These are 18 gauge heavy duty. These come through Parallel Miner as well. This is a 16 gauge heavy duty cable that comes through Parallel Miner. So we would plug in our 6-pin like so. Then we could run both of these up to a single GPU, or we could run one to a GPU and one to the same riser. You really want to try to keep a single cable going to a single set of GPU and risers, or just to a single GPU or single riser. So then the next steps are to wash, rinse, and repeat. Hook up all of your GPUs and all of your risers to the additional 6-pin PCIe connectors. And then that really is the full setup. And then the only other additional item you may need to hook up is if you're running a dual server power supply setup, you would want to connect your ZSX breakout board to your additional breakout board. Here I have an X11, for example, and I would run a mini 4-pin cable from over here in your remote section, and then I would run it over into the 4-pin remote section on my X11 board. And what this would do is it will trigger this breakout board when there is power going to this breakout board. And then when you hit your power switch on this breakout board, it's going to power this on and simultaneously signal this and power this on. And this is what you would want to do if you were running more than one server power supply in tandem with a ZSX game changer or a ZSX amp. Tips and tricks. Whereas this breakout board has a vast array of compatible server power supplies, please check the power supply compatibility list on Parallel Miner's website to ensure that you are using this with a compatible server power supply. Next, the remote Molex section on this breakout board right here. Make sure that you do not plug anything into this unless you are using a remote management module from Parallel Miner, because there have been reports of users improperly plugging this Molex into here, which has caused a backfeed into the breakout board and has caused damage to their new ZSX Game Changer board. Lastly, make sure to plan out your build. Having an integrated hub such as this one will have many wires coming into it. If you do not properly plan, you can end up with a rat's nest of wires, and nobody wants that. And finally, shipping on this item begins on April the 8th. They are already accepting pre-orders on the Parallel Miner website. I know for certain that the ZSX Game Changer sells through very quickly, and I do not expect this board to be any differently. Make sure to click the links down in the description, hop over and pre-order you one, or hop over and order yourself one. You will not be disappointed with this item. Let's hop over into the outro. Not all mining equipment is created equal. Let Parallel Miner outfit you with the most power and cost-efficient solutions. Make sure to jump over to Parallel Miner's website. Links will be down in the description. Check out their vast array of mining products and accessories. If you like the video, you know what to do. Make sure to like and subscribe for future content. Thanks for coming along and enjoy the ride.